month. Everybody's like, oh my God, look at her. Man, Jared, good job last month. Buddy, entitlement comes in. Ego, you're f***. It's the first thing to sink a person. All right, before we get started, I want you to do me a favor. If you've been here before, right, sometimes you could accidentally think that you know what it is that I'm going to say, and I like that. Let me ask you a question. Can you do exactly what I do? If you've been here before, if you've been here, Salvador Rios, you've been here before, right? I should be able to take Salvador, place him right here in the middle of the room, and he should be battle-tested. I should be able to put massive pressure on him from all angles, price, trade, payment, any objections, any scenario he should be ready for. If he's not ready, it's because he's disconnected and he got unplugged. Let me explain something to you and I'll make it as easy as possible, okay? This is your life. Whose life is it? Yours. What does that mean? How big do you want it? Do you know there's a pretty good chance that you want your life to be bigger than most people want your life to be? Do you know there's a chance of that? Do you know that along the way everybody's gonna try to convince you that the life that you're thinking that you're gonna have is pretty freaking stupid? Do you guys understand that? Let's just lay down the foundation so you can understand, number one, while I'm teaching you, why I'm training you, why you probably helped, chose me to help mentor you, is that I worked in the same dealership that you guys worked in. Same one. Top guy, made 110, 150 grand, 200 grand. That was the dough back in the day. That was a lot of money. You're making 200 grand. That's like the 500 for today. Does that make sense? I mean, we're in a different market now. Back then, you were making 200. You were one of the best in the world. Well, guess what? I made 700 next to a guy making 200. Along that way, every single person tried to convince me that I had gotten lucky. I do believe I'm the luckiest motherfucker alive. I'm gonna be honest with you. You better feel that same way about yourself too. Do you hear me? You don't feel like you're lucky? Don't be surprised when nothing good happens to you. I feel like I'm the luckiest man that ever lived, okay? You need to feel the exact same way. But I'm gonna tell you this, so I'm in the store. First month, come out in January, put 70 grand on her ass. How do you think that made him feel? Hate. Hate. Jealousy, envy, lucky. We're gonna make sure that he never makes that kind of money again. And you knew what? I knew that they were gonna do that. So you know what I did? I went harder on it. Understand this, as you're going to higher levels of success, you're gonna have to become more mentally strong for two reasons. Number one, the most obvious reasons why people stop making it is they self-destruct themselves, okay? You have the best month of your life, you have a good month. Everybody's like, oh my God, look at her. Man, Jared, good job last month. Buddy, entitlement comes in, ego, you're f***. It's the first thing to sink a person, ego and entitlement, okay? How can you grow when you think you made it? Am I right? Go back to the reasons why you've ever grown. It's because you went back to zero. Do you feel me? Right now, I hope that some of you in here are dead broke. Take that feeling inside when you were broke. You didn't have anything and you wanted it so bad, man. You were willing to run over anybody in your way. You were willing to do whatever it takes. You were showing up to win. You were playing to win. You remember? You guys remember? Okay? Where did it go? Where'd it go? Who took it? I'm gonna tell you this, that right there, you have to hold on to that till you die. You can never let that leave. That's your raw instinct that will allow you to win. Do you feel me? You ever think you make it? Here's the problem why most people can't scale. S-C-A-L-E. Past 200 grand. You can't because you think you've made it and it comes in and you get comfortable. A dealership's doing great. Travis, you got a store, right? You're doing good. Profits are up. You're killing it. Best year ever. You're building another store. All of a sudden, your buddies are calling you, congratulating you. Hey, good job. I'm getting the other store, man. You know, I knew you were going to make it. By the way, the people that are telling me knew he was going to make it are the people actually were hoping he wasn't going to make it in the beginning. Okay, and they're actually telling him that he was a loser, and today they're calling and congratulating him, and they're telling him everybody knew that they knew that he was gonna make it. Listen, I'm gonna tell you this. Make your winning so undeniable that you're so good at what you do that it makes people literally regret ever not believing you. Okay? Make them feel embarrassed. Do you feel me? And that's the state that I work with, guys. Listen, I'm gonna tell you this. Do you think winning is pretty? Do you think it's saying into yourself three times in the mirror, I'm gonna be a winner, I'm gonna be a winner, I'm gonna be a winner? No, it's having the mindset that you're not gonna break, you're not gonna quit, and you're not gonna stop. And I'm gonna tell you this, you guys can look back over your life and realize anytime that your marriage went away, right? Anytime you got disconnected with your kids, anytime that anything that you thought was gonna happen didn't go through and happen, it's because of you. You lost your edge. You lost it. You started with it, it was a great idea. You started growing it, and then you gave it away.